All right, I know our last one is a little video is a little bit longer, so I'm going to try to get through this as quick as I can, but we do have some work to go do here. So, again, we're working on using if-then movements to solve equations. So it says you're designing a rectangular pet pen for your new baby puppy. How cute. Okay, so here's my pen. Drawing pictures is so helpful, you guys. We know we have 30 feet total. And we want the length to be 6 1/3 feet longer than the width. So it really doesn't matter what you make the width or the length, but if I say this is the width, then it's a rectangle, so the other side has to be the same. And if we want it to be 6 1/3 feet longer, I'm going to take whatever the width is, and I'm going to add 6 1/3 feet to it. And of course, the other side has to be the same. Okay, so getting this visual here kind of helps us see what our dimensions are. Now, we need to write expressions to represent the width and the length. So I am going to say my width is just W. And my length, which I actually already did this, is whatever the width is plus 6 1/3. Okay. So now let's figure it out. Okay. We know that it equals 30 total. So when we come down here to find the dimensions, I basically just have to add all of this up. So I'm just going to go around here. W plus 6 1/3, that's the length there, plus this W, plus this bottom here, W plus 6 1/3. Okay, and we know that has to equal all the way around it, perimeter there, 30 feet. So I'm going to swing all the way over here and do 30. Okay, I know it seems really confusing, but remember this is a width and this is a width, this is the top in my picture, and that's the bottom. Okay, so I just went around and added them all up. That's what made it nice about a drawing. Now let's simplify. Okay, let's simplify this equation. Remember, these W's really have ones in front of them. They're 1 W's. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4 W's plus 6 1/3 plus 6 1/3. 6 1/3 plus 6 1/3. 6 plus 6 is 12. 1/3 plus 1/3 is 2/3. Okay, and you can always do the math off to the side if you want. That equals 30. Okay. All right, so now let's solve this equation using our if-then moves. This equals this. If that's true, which it is, then I am going to get rid of whatever's being added or subtracted to it first. So I'm solving for this W, get rid of this part first. Since it's plus 12 and 2/3, I'm going to minus 12 and 2/3. Think back to when we dealt with opposites, right? These two things combine to give me zero. Okay? I got rid of it, and it works as long as it's on this side. All right, so then we bring down 4W. Like I said, those are opposites, they cancel. Equals, if I subtract here, I'm just going to do it real quick. You could do it off to the
Hey,
side.
Stick Man again. Woo!
This is a different video.
Me
They don't know what Stick Man is, so tell them really quick. You got 2 seconds. Go.
this could be Stick Man and the end of month, at the end of the week there's gonna be a surprise for one piece of candy and a poster coming on our website. So check the website out if this comes out and goodbye.
Goodbye. All right, so there's a hidden sixth layer you gotta look for from Jack. Okay, so anyway, back to our problem here. 30 minus 12 and 2/3 is going to be 17 and 1/3. You could do the math off to the side. When you subtract, that's what you get. Now, since we're solving for W, since this is multiplying, we're going to divide. I'm going to divide both sides by 4. 4 divided by 4 is 1W. Now, right here, we need to go, and I'm going to change this to an improper fraction. So I'm going to go 3 times 17 plus 1, and that gives us 52. So I have 52/3 divided by 4. So I'm going to raise 4 over 1. Keep it, switch it, flip it, take the reciprocal. There's that word again. Okay. And then you can multiply straight across here. You get 52 over 12. If you cross reduce, 1 and 3 have a common factor of 1. 52 and 4, though, have a common factor. 4 goes into itself one time, it goes into 52 13 times. And you basically get 13 times 1, which is 13, over 3 times 1, which is 3. So we have 13/3 our width is equal to, or 3 goes into 13 4 times, and there's 1/3 left over. Okay, so our width is equal to 4 1/3. So if I'm going to come back up top, maybe, okay, width is equal to 4 1/3 feet. That's what these sides would be. To figure out our length, I'm going to add 4 and 1 third, that's what W is, plus 6 and a third. And that works out to be 4 plus 6 is 10, 1 third plus 1 third is 2 thirds. Okay? Since it wanted us to find the dimensions, these are the dimensions there. So feel free to pause this at any point and copy things down. For the sake of time, though, I am going to move things on. All right. Might see a stick figure right here. It says the sum of two consecutive, that means an order, odd numbers is 68. Okay. So consecutive odd numbers. Think of our odd numbers, right? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, right? Those would be consecutive odd numbers. They're odd numbers that come in order. So we need two consecutive odd numbers that add, because that's what sum means, to 68. So I have two numbers here. I'm going to call our first odd number x. So I'd say let x be the first odd number. Now, our second number then, what are we going to add to it? Well, what do we do to get 9 from 7? What do we do 9 to get 11? What do we do to 11 to get 13? Well, we add 2 each time, okay? So if I let x be my first odd number, my second odd number, my second consecutive odd number is going to be 2 more, okay? Hint, it works the same way for even numbers. If x is your first even number, your next consecutive even number will be plus 2, okay? If it just had consecutive numbers, like 7, 8, 9, we would just add 1 each time. All right, so we know the sum of these two, sum means to add, so I'm going to add them together, has to equal 68. So now let's simplify and solve. How many x terms do I have? Here's the simplifying that comes into effect. If I have 1x and 1x, that's 2x's, plus 2 equals 68. Now let's use our if-then movements to solve. If these two things' sides are equal, which they are, then we can subtract 2 from both sides. And again, we always start order of operations in reverse. Whatever's being added or subtracted to get rid of that first. Plus 2 minus 2, that's 0. It cancels out. And I'm left with 2x equals 68 minus 2, which is 66. This is multiplying. We undo multiplying with dividing. So if these two things are equal, if as long as I divide both sides by the same number, we will get what x equals. So x equals 33. Great. That's our first odd number. The next odd number then would be two more than that, 35. So if it says find the numbers, they're 33 and 35. Okay, so here's a hint for something that you're going to see on your homework, okay? One more real quick. If we look in our stick figure here, Barry's mountain bike weighs 6 pounds more than Andy's. The bikes weigh 42 pounds altogether. How much does Barry's bike weigh? So we have Andy's bike and Barry's bike. And I really think, guys, it's helpful if you write this off to the side. Let's let Andy, we'll call his bike weight X. Whatever variable you want to use is fine, okay? But we know Barry's mountain bike weighs 6 more than Andy. So if Andy's is X, Barry's is plus 6. It's 6 more pounds. So if Barry's is 10, I'm sorry, if Andy's is 10, Barry's is 16. If Andy's 15, Barry's is 6 more, 21. But altogether, it weighs 42 pounds. So just like we did in the previous example, we're going to add these together. We have Andy's bike and Barry's bike altogether equal 42. So if we have 1x and 1x, that's 2x's plus 6 equals 42. And then we subtract 6 from each side. And I get 2x equals, 42 minus 6 is 36. And then I'm going to divide both sides by 2 because multiplying, we undo it by dividing. 2 divided by 2 is 1x, and 36 divided by 2 is 18. So the bike, Andy's bike, weighs 18 pounds. Barry's bike weighs 6 pounds more than that, so 24 pounds. Okay. So we're really in this lesson just working more on solving equations and using that idea is as long as you, whatever you do to one side, you do the other, you get a true equation as well.